And welcome back to Attorneys on Call. Thank you so much for joining us here today. And in studio, Bob Whitley and Ben Whitley from the Whitley Law Firm. And anytime you want, you can call that 800 number on your screen, because if you're thinking you might need an attorney, that's the best thing to do. Just call that 800 number. It's free. There's no charge. Or you can go to thewhitleylawfirm.com. You can also send an email if you'd like. That's also free. And one of the attorneys will be getting back to you promptly. Gentlemen, I know that you pride this firm on personal service and Bob being an advocate, you know, for people. Ben, I think that's very evident in the fact that people can call you, they can meet with you. That initial consultation is, there's no charge for that, right? And a lot of times you're going to counsel the person on a plan of action.
Right, and I think part of personal service is service to the community, and the community we serve is the state of North Carolina. So one of the things that we've also done is that we've produced DVDs, which are also free, that will let you know what you need to know if you've been in a car accident. So anyone at any time can call the 800 number that's on the screen now and or go to the website and request one of these DVDs that we'll send to you free of charge that Bob, my dad, has made that goes through a lot of the things that we're talking about today. So maybe if you've caught a part of the show and you want to have more information, I really encourage everyone to request those DVDs. We also have one that my brother Whit did on workers' compensation cases. Okay. And I'm going to talk a little bit later about workers' compensation case, but those DVDs are free, and that's part of our commitment to service and service to the community, which is our state.
Bob, serious accidents, something we have in North Carolina that a lot of people may not understand is this contributory negligence. Can you explain what that is in layman's terms for people like me that are not lawyers?
Well, we're one of only, I believe, four states that are left in the country that still have pure contributory negligence.
Okay.
And what that means is if the person who's injured or killed in any way contributes to the injury or the incident, then they recover absolutely nothing. It's a complete bar. Now, that may not sound so bad, but when you project that in the light that most states follow, which is called comparative negligence, means, for example, Drew, if you were in a wreck and maybe you were on your cell phone and you weren't paying quite as much attention as you should, but somebody runs through a stop sign
and smashes you.
And if they find that you were on the phone and maybe you were going a few miles over the speed limit, then they may deny your claim on the basis of contributory negligence. They will admit that their driver ran the stop sign, that our driver was at fault. But we believe that your client, Mr. Whitley, or the person who's injured, was contributed to it.
Okay.
And so if that goes to a jury and a jury finds that, the jury's ask a question, was the plaintiff injured by the negligence of the defendant? Yes or no? Yes, the defendant ran through the stop sign. Then they go, did the plaintiff contribute to his injury in any way? And if they say yes, they don't get to the third issue, which is the amount of damages. And that's a harsh law. I hope some legislators are listening, because we need to change that law. We need to get in conformity with most states in this country. And remember, that means if you are a little bit at fault and you're the injured party, you pay for that, because your recovery is going to be reduced by the percentage of your responsibility. But it doesn't make sense to me that a big old trucking company who has a lot of insurance because all of the wrecks they cause are going to be serious is driving down the road, but because a person maybe did something a little bit wrong and is only 1% at fault in the whole 100% of the wreck,
they get nothing?
They get zero.
Zero.
Where a person a mile away in another state that doesn't have contributory negligence, they're going to recover 99%. What that law is doing, ladies and gentlemen of the legislature, it's letting the responsible party off the hook. That's all it's doing. And it's putting that responsibility on the taxpayers for Medicaid and to take care. This person may be injured so badly they never are able to work again, but they can't recover anything because of their 1% negligence. And that's, it's not just in the results from jurors, Drew. It goes over, it carries over to settlements. We were mediating a case recently, a very serious case, and kind of similar circumstance. Somebody's run a stop sign,
okay.
But our client was not perfect. It was raining, and maybe he was going 2 or 3 miles an hour faster than he should have. So the other side is saying, well, if we try this case, we're going to argue contributory negligence. They can't be certain that it's going to happen, but we can't be certain that it's not going to happen.
Sure.
Client looks to us, says, is it possible that I would get zero? Yes. Well, you can imagine what that does to your negotiating mentality. You've got to settle oftentimes for much less than you should settle, because the bad thing that could happen could be a zero, which would be a disaster. So I hope it gets changed. I can't imagine any logical reason for us to continue to have it.
Just another example of why this program is so important. This is free legal information from Bob Whitley, who's been practicing law for many, many years in the state of North Carolina. WhitleyLawFirm.com, the 800 number on your screen. Operators are standing by live right now, so if you'd like to call them, go ahead and do that right now. Ben, what your dad was saying about that contributory negligence, if there's only 4 states in the union that still have this, it would seem to me that that's a very archaic law,
right,
and it does need to be changed.
And I'll tell you, I'll give you an example of the other extreme of it, and that would be if, and I see this in people who call that are injured as pedestrians. So if there's a busy street in Raleigh and it doesn't have a crosswalk, and somebody is trying to cross and walk to the other side of the street, and they dart out into traffic, okay, and they haven't waited for a light, they're taking this risk on their own, and they know that it's risky. And they get hit by a car, but then they want to bring a claim against the car. Now, that's almost a fair application of contributory negligence.
Okay.
And I'll explain how other states handle this, because that person is not only 1% at fault, they're probably more than 50% at fault. There might be even 90% at fault. Okay.
Okay.
And that person shouldn't recover, right? Because they've taken this own risk of theirs to jump out in the middle of a busy street. Most states, even let's say our neighbor to the south, South Carolina, has this idea that if you're more than 50% at fault, you don't recover, just like you wouldn't here for 1%. Okay.
Okay.
But if you're 10% at fault, like in this situation that Dad said about the 1 or 2 miles per hour over the speed limit,
right,
then you would still be able to recover in South Carolina.
Okay.
You may have your amount reduced by 10%, but you would still recover.
Your recovery would be reduced by that amount.
It would be. Okay. So if the jury gave you $100, you would get $90.
Okay.
Okay. But if in South Carolina they found you to be more than 50% at fault, like the example I gave with jumping out into the road, then you don't recover anything. That is a much more fair application of how these defenses work, because that's in fact what we're talking about. So when somebody calls us, and perhaps they've gotten denied by the insurance company, and they may not be hurt, and they've got a property damage issue, that means that they've got their car has been damaged, and the insurance company is giving them a hard time, and they may have a witness that says that they were in the right, and the insurance company is hemming and hawing, because that insurance company knows that they're not going to find an attorney that they can pay. By the time you pay an attorney to go fight that case in court, you will have paid out more than you could potentially recover. And unfortunately, the insurance companies know that. But here's a trick that I will tell you, in kind of an insider tip, that you can file your own lawsuit in North Carolina in small claims court. They have changed, about 2 years ago, they changed the amount that you can ask for. So you can ask for up to $10,000 in small claims court. It will cost you the filing fee, and every county is different, so I would call your county clerk. But you don't need a lawyer, and maybe some of my colleagues wouldn't want me on television telling you this, but you can do that, and that's access to the courts. And it goes through the magistrate system, and you would go to you get a hearing date. You would tell the judge what happened. If you had any witnesses, they would be there.
Okay.
And the judge may decide in your favor and order that insurance company to help pay for your car, or if there was just maybe one doctor visit. But in practical speak, if you file that small claims action, that insurance company may call you up and want to settle your case. And that's a secret that I think a lot of people
don't
realize.
That's a great secret.
Yeah, because
absolutely.
You have, and I tell this, I spend time with people on the phone to explain that, is that in these cases that are small cases, you know, guess what? You can go to court without a lawyer. You're going to pay the filing fee, but it may force the insurance company into a settlement situation. And then you would have saved a lot of money for legal expenses doing that.
What's it like dealing with those insurance adjusters? Because it happened to me. I got in a wreck, and the other person was responsible for the wreck, ran a red light, crashed into me. And immediately, I'm getting a call from her insurance company and the adjuster offering me $500 to settle my case. Mm-hmm. And immediately. And so I, first thing I said to him was, I need to talk to my attorney, and that left it at that. And so,
Drew, didn't they also want to get your version of what happened? Or did they?
You know, it was a while ago, Bob, and I think what he did say is, I understand my client ran a red light and crashed into your car, but we'll pay for your car damages.
Let me give you a more common phone call that our clients get, or the callers that call us get.
Okay.
The insurance company wants to interview you, you know, the injured party, to get your version of what happened.
Yeah.
And if you're not going to have a lawyer, you're probably going to have to do that. But the tips that I would have for those people is, you know, be honest, answer the questions, but don't answer any more than what they ask you. And if they can ask you, if they ask you a question that you can answer yes or no, do it. Don't be afraid to say, I don't know. Because they'll do things like, well, how far away was the car, was our car from you when you first saw it? And if you say, I don't know, maybe 100 yards, hey, red light's going off with that adjuster. Like, okay. Well, if he was that far away, he could have avoided it, and he might be contributory negligent.
Oh,
so don't be afraid to say you don't know if you don't know.
And just leave it at that.
And almost never volunteer distances and time, because you're not going to know. I mean, you know, well, how long did it take before, when you first saw it, that you got hit? I don't know. Well, how far away from it was that car when it pulled out? You know, I don't know, but it was right on me. I know it was so close I couldn't avoid it. But don't get tied down to 50 feet or whatever it is.
Yeah, I got you. Ben, we're going to have to take a short break in a minute, but when we come back, I'd like to hear some other calls that you get, and we'll talk about workers' compensation claims as well, because I know that can be an extremely difficult process for a claimant to deal with, and why it's so important to have an attorney, especially a local attorney, handling your case. This is Attorneys on Call. We're back in just a moment. Stay right there.